a point about weapon and armor breakage in role-playing games. Hello, I'm Chris, otherwise known as GM Chance, and welcome to Of Horrors and Heroes, a tabletop role-playing YouTube channel which focuses on tips, tricks, suggestions, opinions, reviews, and actual play. I focus on a range of different games in this channel, but devote most of my commentary towards my favorite game, Rolemaster. Really hope you find something interesting and useful for your game in what you're about to watch. And if you do, I'd love either a comment down below, a like, or even better, a subscribe. Thanks very much. So the topic of today's video is weapon breakage in tabletop role-playing games, and perhaps provide some ideas what you might be able to do to spice up and add a bit more risk with a broken sword or a broken spear in your game. So, weapon breakage in role-playing games. Why should you do it? Do you do it? And if you don't do it, maybe you should. So this here is a M1822 French light cavalry saber. I don't know if the camera can pick this up, but it's a really solid piece of metal. And it says, you know, its category is a lightsaber, but it's got some heft. It's got some weight behind it. And, you know, the metal is appears to be well forged and well made. It's got some spring to it, but, you know, it's a solid piece of metal. And you can almost not imagine how can an object like this potentially break, particularly when you're coming up against at least what this weapon was for. Unarmored, typically, foes. But historical records and historical accounts absolutely do outline that weapons broke, and broke with a reasonable amount of regularity. A guy by the name of Matt Easton from a absolutely fantastic YouTube channel by the name of Scholar Gladiatoria put out a video some time back talking about weapon breakage. Particularly around sword versus wooden hafted weapons, so halberds and spears and the like. The premise of one of the premises of Matt's of that particular video by Matt was that weapons would break today with good quality metal, but they would have broken probably a lot more in the past with frankly poorer quality steel. That people were using. And Matt himself has seen a number of occasions where good quality swords and other weapons have been broken in front of him. He also explains in his video and puts up some images of medieval paintings and artwork and manuscripts of a European battlefield with all kinds of broken spears and swords and etc. lying on the ground. Weapons broke, and they broke probably at the most inopportune moments. In terms of Matt's credentials, he, as well as being a prolific YouTuber, he is an antique arms dealer based in the UK, and perhaps even more interestingly, he is a practitioner of HEMA, or historical European martial arts. So he knows the objects that he's talking about from like an academic point of view, but also as a martial artist, as someone who actually has trained with these things, he kind of knows how to use them as well. So I found his video really interesting and quite thought-provoking. And I guess the topic of today is thinking about how we can take the idea of, you know, a solid metal object that in theory you really don't want it to break and it shouldn't break, but it does, and probably the absolute wrong moment. So, weapon or equipment breakage in tabletop role-playing games. Some games already have rules baked in, and they're just simply part of the game system. If yours doesn't, as I mentioned earlier on, strongly encourage you to think about doing so. Why? Well, the hobby that we love is all about telling an interesting story, or the GM at least facilitating the ability for an interesting story to be told. And to tell an interesting story, often there needs to be an element of risk. Interjecting a chance, and I always think it should be a very small chance, but a chance nevertheless, that a critical weapon or a critical piece of equipment could possibly break, just makes every combat that little bit more risky, that little bit more dangerous, that little bit more, ooh, is this a good idea or not? So often, certainly sometimes in various games, you'll come across a situation where the heroes, where the party are out and they're confronted by, you know, a relatively low-powered group of opponents. It could be the proverbial goblins, it could be the proverbial kobolds, a group of muggers armed with a dagger, you know, daggers and clubs. In theory, not particularly huge threat to the player characters. And the lead fighter in the party steps up and in the first round of combat swings their longsword. And lo and behold, on that very first swing, there's a horrible noise. And that prize longsword shatters into multiple pieces. And suddenly, that kind of yawn fest of a fight, you know, suddenly that becomes a lot more interesting. People sit up, players stop playing with their phones. Hopefully they're not playing with their phones that much, but they sit up and they really start engaging, because suddenly what should have been routine suddenly becomes a lot more interesting. Said before, but absolutely the risks should be low. So whatever the mechanic is, whatever mechanic you want to use, it shouldn't come up much. A combination of different dice rolls or whatever it is, it should, you know, the risk of a spear or a sword or a dagger or whatever breaking should not be common. So whatever you determine is an appropriate level or chance of risk should be it, but it should definitely be low. The other comment I'd make too is for magical weapons, enchanted weapons, particularly well-made weapons, they should probably get an additional, call it what you like, a saving throw or additional chance not to break. How do I handle weapon and equipment breakage in my game? Well, my game of choice is my beloved Rolemaster, and fair to say there are some pretty comprehensive rules for weapon breakage in that game. However, the edition that I play, Classic or RM2, the breakage rules in that edition of the game I don't like very much. So I've borrowed from a later edition, the standard system. In my game, in our games, when a melee combatant rolls a double number, so that would be either an 11, a 22, a 33, a 44, etc., there is a chance that either their weapon, their opponent's weapon, their opponent's helmet, armor, or shield could potentially break. Small chance, perhaps, but potentially break asunder, and of course, depending on the situation and what's going on, potentially change that battlefield quite considerably. I do house rule that the double zero, which equals 100 in a D percentile system, is sacrosanct, so that doesn't apply. A D100 or a double zero doesn't equate to a breakage roll in our games. In my game, I feel it's a bit mean. You know, it's the highest roll in the game, and you kind of don't want to burst someone's bubble if they've rolled 100 to then see if their sword breaks. Another aspect that I've cannibalized for my house breakage rules are a set of tables that I've come across. So individual tables for either fully metal weapons, wooden hafted weapons, or shields and armor and equipment. Different tables, and they stipulate in each one different results of what could potentially happen for a breakage roll. I've come across those tables from the kindness of another GM, a GM by the name of GM Adam. He runs, by the way, a very good Rolemaster standard system game that you can see on YouTube. called the Greenbrook Adventure, and there'll be a link down below. GM Artem has kindly and graciously allowed me to take those tables and morph them as I see fit, and also to share them here. Thank you very much, GM Artem, very kind of you. So there we have it, some thoughts on weapon breakage and equipment breakage in role-playing games. How an object like this, apparently very sturdy and strong, robust looking object like this, could potentially snap asunder at a very inopportune moment in one of the fights in your gaming session, and what that could mean for the story. As mentioned, please have a look at the house rules down below. You're very welcome to cannibalize, use, adapt, morph, twist as you see fit to incorporate into what you think is useful for your game. And if you'd like a Word copy of the PDF that's listed down below so you can change more easily, I'd be very happy to share it. Happy gaming, and see you in the next video.